Hey guys, in today's video, we're going to talk about getting in the best shape of your life. So this video is more of an intro to what is going to be a really cool series for 2022. What exactly is the best shape of your life? That is obviously subjective, but it is important we define it. Otherwise, how are we going to be able to achieve it? So how do you define it exactly? Is it based on what other people think and how they define it? We're all influenced partially by our culture and our environment, which is obviously made up of other people. So for me, for example, because I'm American,
okay, USA,
getting in the best shape of my life would obviously entail having a six-pack, but that's because I live among a nation of fat asses.
It is the truth.
I don't know what the scientific term is, but essentially, it's not that common to have a six-pack, especially if you're older. So that usually makes it at least seem like you're in better shape than the average American. But whether you want to get in the best shape of your life or not, minimum I would encourage you to at least get in better shape than you currently are right now. I mean, that is a journey worth taking. It is a lifestyle worth pursuing. And I'll discuss a lot more about that momentarily, but first, I do want to talk about my sponsor, Let's Get Checked. In order to get adequate results in the gym, you need to be healthy internally. And while I encourage everyone to see their physician and get their yearly checkup, it's actually kind of difficult to get a doctor's appointment nowadays, plus it may not necessarily even be that convenient for you. So the next best thing is to get tested in the comfort and convenience of your own home. Oh, make sure to use my promo code, by the way, VS30, in order to get 30% off for anything you want to get checked, anything you want to get tested. Let's Get Checked offers a whole array of tests that you can order. A lot of you will probably be most interested in the testosterone test, or better yet, the male hormone complete test, which not only checks your testosterone levels, but also your sex hormone binding globulin, prolactin, estradiol, free androgen index, and cortisol. How does Let's Get Checked work exactly? Well, it's simple. You choose your test online, and it will be delivered to you in a discreet packaging with next day delivery as an option. Activate your test and collect your sample in the morning. Return your sample with the prepaid shipping label provided. Once your sample arrives in the laboratory, confidential results will be available from your secure online account within 2 to 5 days. Once your results are available, they will be reviewed by a physician. A nurse will then contact you for an over-the-phone consultation. In some cases, the physician will be able to provide prescriptions to the pharmacy of your choosing. Let's Get Checked laboratories are CLIA approved and CAP accredited, which are the highest ranking levels of accreditation. Let's Get Checked lets you avoid the uncomfortable office visits by providing you with access to home testing and professional medical consultations without ever having to leave your home. It's never been this simple to get tested. I've ordered several tests myself, including the male hormone complete test, cholesterol test, diabetes test, colon cancer screening test, and essential vitamin test. I'm getting it all tested. Health and fitness is really about the long game, longevity. Now, obviously, that's not what sells, which is why you have so many programs and supplements marketed to give you that instant gratification.
All lies and false propaganda.
Or at least the promise of near instant gratification. Those 6 week body transformations. I mean, come on, how many of us tried those? You probably didn't look that much better in 6 weeks. People are just hardwired to want it now, and in some cases it actually makes sense because we're only here for a limited time. I mean, life is short. At least in geological terms, like gone in the blink of an eye. But the way we perceive time, we're actually here for like a decent amount of time. But time is of the essence, which is why I encourage all of you to start now, especially with the new year coming up. Yeah, the new year's resolution, which will at least give most people the fuel they need to go to the gym for a good month or two before they start dropping off like flies. It's the time for gym sales reps to sell you that 12-month membership, knowing full well that you're probably only going to go there for 2 months and just pay for 10 you're never going to use. Hey, I'm just being real, man. I'm just talking about people in general. But I feel you guys and girls are a little bit different. Like, most of you found out about my channel or were brought here because of your love for those action martial arts movie stars and icons of the 80s and 90s. You know, guys like Stallone, guys like Van Damme, who not only defined a generation of weightlifters and martial artists from the 80s and 90s, but inspired us to want to be like them, to want to look like them, to want to move like them. Now, the reason I bring this up is because, at least for me, from a physical standpoint, that is the pinnacle of human potential. Again, from a physical standpoint, to be like our favorite action or martial arts movie star in real life is quite the goal. So I don't practice helicopter kicks because I plan to do that in an alley if I get jumped. I do them because they're cool, because they're fun, and because they're challenging, especially if you're in middle age. And if you can do those, trust me, you could pull off those more functional kicks that you would likely use if you got jumped in an alley. Now, I'm going to chronicle my journey into getting in the best shape of my life in 2022. But the reason I'm doing this is not just to help hold myself accountable, but rather, I believe it will be beneficial to anybody watching to get ideas. I'm going to cover everything. I truly believe experience is the best teacher. So I've been doing this for 27 years, remaining completely natural the entire time. There are simply things I learned in the real world that I could never get from reading a book or taking a course. So I've lived it, I experienced it, I've learned a few things over the last 27 years, and I continue to learn, always have an open mind, always trying new things, always refining. So I feel like I have something beneficial to share with you guys. Now, I don't recommend anybody do exactly what I'm doing verbatim, but I think this can generate ideas that you can incorporate in your own training and diet. So if it does, as I continue this series, I'd love to hear about some of your results and some of the things that maybe sparked ideas for you to try. So make sure in the series, you know, comment down below, DM me on Instagram or Facebook, whatever you want to do. But I would like to hear, you know, feedback and how this may have helped you guys in some way. So as far as like getting in the best shape of my life, for me, the way I'm going to define it, like, it's about balance. There's going to be a give and take, you know, between like strength and endurance, size and leanness, you know, leanness or size. Remember, guys, like, I'm all natural. Like, at this stage in the game, I've been doing it 27 years. I'm not going to significantly gain like a bunch of size and leanness. Like, that's just not going to happen naturally. But I can still make improvements. So for me, it's finding my ideal balance and then peaking. But to me, it's got to be sustainable. It can't be anything extreme that essentially doesn't make life as enjoyable as it should be. But that is not a lackadaisical attitude, by the way, because trust me, it's a lot harder to be consistent throughout the year, remaining near peak at all times. Now, that's not to say I won't take it up a notch or down a notch, but the idea is not to fluctuate too much. So for example, just a few months back before I went to Mexico, I did take things up a notch and I felt like I peaked just before that trip. So obviously in Mexico, I'm gonna be walking around the beach without my shirt on for a lot of the vacation. That was the motivation, the extra motivation I needed to not eat an entire pizza before bed. And then when I was in Mexico, obviously the diet and training actually took down a notch. So, you know, I came back, we had Thanksgiving, we had the holidays, able to maintain for the most part, but now, the new year, it's time to bring things up a notch and try to reach a higher level, a higher peak than what I previously gotten just before I went to Mexico. But to summarize, best shape of my life is what I like to call athletically buff or buff athlete, because I not only want to move and perform like an athlete, martial artist in this case, but I also want to look the part of that Rambo character or that Van Damme character. A nice balance of size and definition. To me, the look and aesthetics are important. So there's definitely a portion of my workout that incorporates isolation type exercises. Now, will that help me be a better martial artist? Well, not necessarily, but I'll look better with my shirt off, and there's nothing wrong with that. So my definition of best shape might be different than yours. Like, I mean, maybe you're an endurance guy and running a faster marathon. If you achieve that, then that would define you as getting in the best shape of your life. Or if you're a power lifter, you know, hitting higher numbers on your three lifts, like the squat, the bench, and the deadlift, that very well may determine whether you're in the best shape of your life. The definition is actually fluid and it can change depending on what your current goals are. But define exactly what it means for you and then go for it.
The only difference between the hero and the coward is the hero is willing to go for it, all right? Willing to take the shot. Forward, left, right.
On a side note, is it just me or is Rocky V severely underrated?